Some time ago, I met up on the bus. I'm always meeting strangers on buses and friends as well. But this time it was a friend by the name of Morris Engel, who's a famous early documentary filmmaker. And he pulled out of his pocket a photograph. Yeah, a photograph that he took from his apartment on the sixth floor around 70th Street on the west side overlooking Central Park. He took the photograph with a panoramic camera, and so that he could see not only the whole park, but the park all the way from the south end at 59th Street to 110th Street, I think it is, where it meets up with Harlem, right? And you see the park and Fifth Avenue and everything beyond. It's a beautiful full scope image of the park. But not just that either. There was one thing in the photograph that made it so extraordinary. A piece of nature that graced that beautiful park and all beyond it. A rainbow that went from Harlem all the way to 59th Street, standing above it all and making it all the more beautiful. Well, you could ask yourself, I suppose, how could an artist, using the means of a human being rather than of nature itself, grace the park in some beautiful fashion? Well, the Christos have managed to do that with their gates project by setting up 7,500 gateways over the walkways of Central Park with simple frames that are some 16 or 18 feet high, 10 or 12 feet wide, according to the width of the walkway. 7,500 of them with a piece of fabric fastened to the top and let loose some 8 feet of it, responding to the wind. I'm so excited that I'll be making a film of that, as I have been filming it now for 25 years, during which time the Christos have struggled with the city to get permission. Finally, this year, I was there when Michael Bloomberg, the mayor, gave the okay. And so it's going to happen. It's going to happen in February. And February 12th, in one day, and almost in one moment, the fabric will descend from each top of each gateway, and the project will begin and last for 16 days, during which time Antonio Ferreira and I will be filming it all. And we're hoping that in January we will have each of us and several other cameramen as well, a new high-definition small camera that is being made by Sony. And hopefully that camera will be ready for us the night before, the month before in January. One way or another, we will capture the full beauty of it. But it's not just the fabric, it's not just the gateway. It's not just everything that Christo can put into this as an artist. It's also the human reaction to it. So we are now spending time filming people in the park. We will be spending a great deal of time filming people in February when the leaves aren't there, when you can get a full view of the gates. We will be filming people of all kinds with all kinds of stories that will erupt in response to what these people are finding as a new environment for them in this beautiful thing called Central Park.